Right, ladies and gents, I'm now on the 650, Kawasaki 650, to Twin. Feels lovely. Well, mate, go on. Took an accurate exhaust on it as well, actually. Oh, it feels very, very weird. I feel like I'm on a 250 or something. This is very strange. No, I'm actually... It's very tiny. I mean, my knees are bending. I mean, I don't have this much clearance. I mean, I'm, like, only just flat-footing on my XSR, so this is a lot lower. I'm sat right in the seat. I'll say this is not a review. This is just my first ride experience of this bike, which I've never been on before. But... It does feel rather nice. It's, I don't know, gimmicky almost, I think, is the word. I mean, I don't want to offend anybody who has one of these bikes. It definitely won't have an auto blipper like my, I wish it was mine, the ZX10. It's comfortable. So it's a Kawasaki, I think it's a Z650, I think that's what the class it has now. So I would say you've got the Z650, the Z900 and the Z1000. Do they have the 8? I think they had the 8. They might not have it now, but they used to. But this, pleasantly surprised by the little thing. It's kind of nice. It's nothing that I would, like, shout from the rooftops about. It's just a bike, but it's a good bike. It feels well enough built. It's that little screen's all right. Like, it's plasticky, but it's not, I mean, what else are you going to get? No idea how much this bike's going to be. I would say probably retail about six grandish. It won't be far off. Oh, that's raspy. Suspension's plush. Suspension sounds all right. It sounds all right. The exhaust sounds all right. But the suspension's, it soaks up the bumps just nicely. I think there's a lot of disappointed people as well today, to be honest with you, because of the amount of people that's turned up and they've missed out. Really, for these events, you need to turn up as early as possible. And as I said in the ZX10 video, whether or not you picked it up or not, I would suggest going over the bike beforehand, just double checking, take some photos of bits and pieces if there's like maybe a bit of scratching on the paintwork or something like that. Because the last thing you want is to go back and the keys in, and then they come over to you and say, listen, there's paint on the scratch on the paintwork and stuff like that, because they'll hold you responsible. So any type of demo days, anything like this, do that. Just make those, I don't know, the final preparations before you go on the bike. Just have a quick look over, like I did with this one. I didn't really see anything noticeable, not like the ZX10, which had big scratch down the tank. This one's got a slight one there, but it looks like the paint's sort of blemished. What's weird is they've got the orange, like an orange coloured, like a burnt orange coloured one of this that sat there, which looked nice. It actually looked bigger than this, I think, because it was orange. It made it look wider. I think because of this is such a, I don't know, maybe a brighter green than what the orange, or the orange was darker. This actually, even though it is bright, it looks slimmer. Engine sounds nice. Comfortable suspension. It looks quite nice. I've got to give it that. It definitely looks the part. I would say the baby of the Z range, possibly. I don't know what else they do in the Z range now. The Kawasaki change stuff all the time. But it's a good beginner bike. I can feel a bit of vibration through the bars. Not a lot, but there is some there. It's enough to probably warrant, maybe, I don't know, putting some grips on, some better grips that maybe reduce the vibration, but it's definitely noticeable. Even now, just on them roads, there's no real vibration. I can't feel through the pegs, but other than that, it's fairly comfortable, as I say. I mean, you can see the rear end because Lado's on the burnt orange version of it, which I'll try and if I can, let's have a little look. Can you see burnt orange? The brakes are all right. No, it's a nice bike. It's not something that I would run out and buy, because obviously I've already got what I've got. I would definitely not replace my XSR with this. I would replace my XSR with a ZX10, but that's a different story. But this, yeah, nice. So I would say final thoughts, lovely, comfortable. It looks actually quite nice. It's small and compact. A little bit of vibration in the bars, as you can probably tell by Lado there. He's having a bit of issues. Probably usually that's a sign of vibration. But no, it's nice, comfy. Yeah. So yeah, the next video is probably going to be the track session. I'm hoping I can get away with trying to get the bike on the camera on my chest, because I'm not going to be able to do it on my helmet. And we'll see how we go. But if you've enjoyed this little first ride of the Z650, if I've got that wrong, then I'll change it in the description. But go and check it out if you're looking for a bike, possibly something for a beginner. It's a lovely little bike. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you hopefully on the track. Please, because what a nightmare it's been. Yesterday was a god awful day riding down here, 30 odd degrees, stupidly ridiculously hot, and I'd lost my license, and then miraculously found it inside my bag just as I was heading into the garage to go and sign on for the demo riding bikes. Anyways, catch you later. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed this, and I'll see you later.